Jason is 12 years old. Like many boys his age, he's preoccupied with grades and sports and music. But unlike most kids, Jason has lived his entire life with a congenital heart condition known as a single ventricle defect. 30 years ago, single ventricle defects were almost universally fatal. Babies died within days of birth. 12 years ago, when Jason was born, care had advanced to the point that many children would survive the 3 open-heart surgeries required to treat the condition, but whether and how they would grow up was still a question. Stosh is 6 months old. He too was born with a single ventricle defect. As his parents take joy in watching his first year milestones, sitting, standing, speaking his first words, they can also expect that Stosh will have a much more optimistic outlook. This is the story of 2 boys, 1 program, and years of medical progress. It is a story of discovery, dedication, and hope.
A single ventricle type of congenital heart defect is one in which, in essence, there is only one functioning pumping chamber from the lower parts of the heart.
In you and me and most of the people we see on the street, we have 2 pumping chambers. One of them is responsible for pumping the blood to our bodies and the other to our lungs.
So the right side of the heart that pumps blood over to the lungs is essentially blood that your body's already used. It comes back to the heart as blue blood. Once it goes and circulates through the lungs, it gets oxygenated. We refer to that as red blood or oxygenated blood, and that's what comes back to the left side of the heart that then pumps it out for your body to use again.
And when a valve inside the heart doesn't form or a pumping chamber doesn't form, that is what is considered to be a single ventricle abnormality. So by the time of birth, the baby really only has one functional pumping chamber to pump blood to the body or to the lungs.
It's not a single anatomic lesion. It includes a constellation of a variety of very, very different types of anomalies, all of which essentially share the common finding of only a single functioning pumping chamber.